aware of where this Monkey King is.
Yeah, instant pings out on mid coming out. I see if Snake King's plans to get out of there if he wants to sort of start something and tank it. He's going to be jumped on. So optically to initiate onto Snake King. Snake King gets forced to the side by SVG, but still goes down the once. Do they want to try and take this five stone? That's the question. Looks like they won't. They'll say, Snake King, you're going down here. They'll let him go. Opt to get the kill on the Wraith King, and they can look towards Roshan. Snake King does have buyback, though. So Storm, they should know that the Optic have gone straight towards this. And Optic, they look like they want to try and find more kills before they really commit for it. UR gets the leap up to the high ground. They'll go for the Yule's play, but the Terrorize comes out. As CCC did not pop the BKB before looking to do that combo. The root comes through onto PPD. PPD's gone. Buyback as well from Snake King. As they look to keep this fight going, they'll turn towards 33. They'll chuck him up in the end. Now CCC looks to fight back with the BKB. Going on to this Snake King where he can once. They'll take him down. He didn't have Reincarnate back up in time. BKB from Pycat as Pycat looks to chase down SVG. SVG looks for the Jukes up to the high ground. But 33, hot on the case. Trying to chase. The Moonlight Shadow comes out. Do those two have detection upon them? They don't. Zai, does he either?
No,
he does not. So SVG, he can hide. He should be okay, but still, Optic more than happy with that one as they get MSS. And they are able to kill Snake King that third time effectively as he buys back for that fight.
Such a great position of a fight for them there. CCNC kind of runs in, and with all this armor that we're talking about, you know, 28 armor, he's getting pretty tanky. 26 Bloodstone charges, infinite mana pretty much in the fights. Oh, Shiva's, that was the Shiva's on there.
That was a deep Rezo with a massive courier find there by this, the secret shop of Optic Gaming.
Zai.
Are they going to look to get in the pit in time? Optic trying to finish this one off. SVG, he has been found by the Balls of Zai. They found him, he's finally found his hiding place.
Optic does not kill the Roshan at fast time.
They will get SVG, though. Double Edge from 33 finishes him off, so that's another hero down on Storm. Snake King's going to be back up in 12. SVG buys back. They really don't want to let this Roshan go the way of Optic.
Now with the Flesh Golem, this is where the amplification comes through. They're going to start killing it a bit faster. Storm has to be prepared.
Resolution. Starting to send illusions in, trying to get the vision so he knows the info and how low it is. Jawar coming in from the side. He's got the BKB back up and he's looking to take the Tombstone down straight away. Tombstone's gone, leaps back out, keeps the distance. SVG getting thrown up into the air. Snake King leaning forward, looking on to go on top of 33. Pike up with the BKB. Straight with the boundless strike onto the two of them. Jawar's got another leap, trying to escape. 33 jumps forward with the double edge. They get the slow. Pike up with the vision, jumps down. They'll get him. They'll take Jawar down, and Jawar buys back straight away. Back towards the pit. Snake King drops once. Resolution focusing down Zai. Finds the eye of Zai. He's got the Ghost Scepter. Buys him a little bit of time, but he doesn't have to have a backup for a second. So he will still fall. Resolution gets the double straight buybacks from both Pycat and Zai. Over towards the side. 33 still sort of keeping Yawar and MSS drawn away from the pit. He will die for it though. Back on mid. Buybacks coming out. A third one now from Optic Gaming. Boundless strike down onto SVG. SVG crumbles. SVG now gone for 60 seconds. The Terrorize thrown out just to keep Optic apart. MSS actually jumping in aggressively. Snake King as well looking to go, but he hasn't got Reincarnate for 10 seconds. Snake King sort of be careful. Resolution focusing down CCC. No BKB for 30 seconds. Pycat trying to come in and help, but he jumps into the bramble.
Pycat,
Yawar, they've got the damage. Pycat's got no BKB, no escape. Pycat, he's dead for 110 seconds. The Illusion's chasing down 33. MSS, Yule's up into the air. MSS keeping himself alive, trying to force away, and MSS survives. He lives. That's going to be 33 gone now for 90 seconds. Him as well without buyback on the sideline. CCC looking for Snake King. Snake King, they put the Reincarnate once. Can they get him a second time? They can't. CCC and C surrounded. BKB's back up in 2 seconds, but it's not soon enough. He'll fall. He's down for only 4 seconds with the high Bloodstone charges that he does have. But Zai hiding on the cliff. But all the auto attack gave his position away. He goes down. PPD as well. VGJ Storm.
Oh my.
Killing Optic over and over again. Numerous diebacks there from Optic Gaming. Roshan, the real winner here, is he still alive. But Storm, after sort of their resilience in that fight, coming out with the buybacks, able to outplay Optic at the end of the day, they'll be rewarded with Roshan and an Aegis and a Cheese.
All right, that was really tough to keep track because we had two fights happening, right?
I had to set my camera up. It was all right.
I was glancing up. You looked like you did great. I saw.